In this video, I'm going to show you how to convert a CSV table to geographic points so you can use it in your maps. So here I am in ArcGIS Pro. First, you'll need to add the CSV to your map. Let's open the catalog panel. Go to View and Catalog Pane. You'll see it pop up on the right-hand side. All you have to do is add it to your map. So I have my CSV stored in Favorites. I'm just going to go ahead and add it by dragging and dropping it into my map. So you're now going to be able to find your table in your table of contents. You'll see it as a standalone table. The CSV that I'm going to convert are airports in North America. First, let's take a look at the table. I'm going to right-click my table. Then, I'm going to select Open. You'll notice that your table will open up in the bottom panel of ArcGIS Pro. The table is really simple. It just has the airport name, latitude, and longitude coordinates. What's important here is that you have geographic coordinates in your table. They could be latitude and longitude, or they could be eastings and northings. No matter what format they're in, you definitely need coordinates. And the only other field I have is the airport name. This all looks good. Let's convert it to a shapefile. So I'm going to right-click my CSV in the table of contents, but this time I'm going to select the Display XY Data option. Okay, so it's already populated most of the fields for me. It has the input table and output feature class already. But in this video, I want to create a shapefile. The default in ArcGIS Pro is that it creates a feature class in a geodatabase. So instead of the default geodatabase, I'm going to paste in the location for my shapefile. I'm also going to make sure that I include SHP as my extension. Okay, that looks good. Now I'm going to have to assign an X and Y field. In my case, the X value is longitude, and the Y value is latitude. The Z field is if you have any elevation values, which I don't. Lastly, I have to assign it a coordinate system. So I have latitude and longitude coordinates in my table, so the GCS WGS 1984 coordinate system is okay. But if you have eastings and northings, then you're likely going to use a UTM coordinate system. This is an important field. Make sure you know the origin coordinate system of your data beforehand. Because if you enter an incorrect coordinate system, your data might end up in the middle of nowhere. So really, all that I have to do is push OK. It looks like it's added some points on my map, and they look like they're in the right location. Everything looks good so far. Let me just open up the table in my new shapefile to make sure the attributes all remain as they're supposed to. Okay, perfect. So in this video, I converted a CSV file into a shapefile using ArcGIS Pro. By specifying the X and Y fields, as well as the coordinate system, the converted data landed exactly where it was supposed to. Converting a CSV to a shapefile means that you're transforming the data format from a plain text file with comma-separated values into a geospatial point format. We created a shapefile as the output format. And even though shapefiles aren't the most efficient format, they still are a standardized format for mapping, visualization, and conducting spatial analysis. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please remember to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more great GIS tutorials. I'll see you next time.